Councilor James Hill.
All right, let's go over this list of children or whatever. We just want to have a couple of testimonials, I think would be great. In our morning prayer on Thursday each week, normally we have Sister Cherie, and she has really impressed me this last few weeks. She's been coming practically every Thursday morning at 5 o'clock, and she had a request that she was presented to the Lord for her family. Now, if you can look back, how many children are you managing today?
Well, I have my four, plus my little sister. I just got her today. My daughter's actually with her dad. It's his turn to have.
Okay.
But I have five still.
Right.
Each week I usually have five.
Usually she has five in prayer. And so that shows that where there's a will, there's a what? There's a way. And has God already begun to work in that? On your behalf?
Yes.
Amen.
He's still working.
All right, she's going to talk. She can talk good. But I just wanted her to encourage you, because whenever you have needs, and whenever you want to make a special request before the Lord, and you really sometimes, I know that sometimes things are in a critical mode, and you really need to do something beyond the norm in order to get God's attention. And she chose to make a sacrifice of coming at 5 o'clock just to present her case before the Lord. Bible says that God is a rewarder of them that will love diligently seek Him. And as a result of her coming, I can say for sure that I can see a real motivation, inspiration. I mean, in other words, the joy of praying in the Holy Ghost and get built up in the Spirit has really began to become very noticeable in her life. So I just want her to just kind of let y'all know what it's like getting four or five children ready for prayer each week at 5 o'clock in the morning, how she does it. And then she has to return home, I guess, to go to work, to be at work. She goes straight to work from here. Amen. So come, let us know how you do all of this, and look this estimate to you. All right.
Amen.
Well, I usually get everything laid out the night before we come, and get my girl's hair done the night before, and all the way I'll have to just brush it up when we get up. But the Lord has been working with me and teaching me to be more patient and dealing with the situation with my niece and getting her in my custody. I've been really praying and coming and staying faithful, because I know in the end I'm going to have all my babies with me. And that is my goal. My sister is unable to take care of them, and that's why they're in my care. And they wouldn't have no other place to go if I didn't take them. So I feel like I owe them the obligation to take care of them and show them the right path and the way that they need to live their life. And I can only do that by setting the example.
That's right.
And me making that sacrifice, it's going to go to bed early, We go to bed usually about 7 o'clock. I feed them, you know, get them ready, bathe, put everybody down to bed, and then I get myself ready and pick out my clothes and their clothes and have it all laid out and get them up. And usually we get up about 3:30 to get ready, because I don't live in Tulsa. I live in Scottsdale. And so usually we're on the road about 4:30, and we're usually here by 5 or maybe a little after 5. But most of the time we're here by 5. Then I drop the kids off, and then I go on to work. It's a routine now. That's part of our daily week. And it really has been paying off and working in my favor. And I believe it will continue to be that way. And I will, by the end of the summer, I will have full custody of my nephews, and I'm just working on my niece next. That's going to be a little challenge, and I'm just staying faithful, knowing that it's going to work out. So that's all. It's nothing really major that I do. I'm just motivated by my children. That's it.
All right. Okay. So you can see that God answers prayer, and He will respond to faithfulness. Amen. So we just thank God for the faithful Sister Sharita and that Sister Shirley Brown's granddaughter.
Yes.
Amen. So Sister Shirley, your prayers are beginning to be answered.
Yeah.
And I was just really amazed at how she has other family members, but God is really beginning to get their attention, and I just thank God that it's beginning with Sister Sharita. So we just praise God for her. Is that good?
Yeah.
Amen. All right, I kind of remind me of Brother James Gaines. Amen. Your first name is James. Okay. Calvin. Okay. But he has his family with him each Sunday. I'm not going to call him to say anything, other than you just want to. But I think that it's remarkable how he has been committed to getting his children to church on Sundays. And I understand that one Sunday, he had them all in Sunday school. And so that motivated us to really begin to get back on our post, because a lot of the children weren't coming consistently. We weren't able to continue the Bible studies for the children on Sunday mornings, but that's going to motivate us to get things back into action so that those children will be able to be in class on Sunday morning. Let's give Brother James.
Brian,
my God, I looked at the wrong card. It's Brian.
Grimes,
okay, Grimes. Yeah, right. I looked at that card this morning. I know I saw Grimes, but I don't know what I said Grimes.
Okay.
Amen. Okay, I want to have one more testimonial. This is kind of a different type of testimonial. Brother Butler, I wanted him to... he's been very faithful about coming to Bible study, Bible study as well, but also prayer on Tuesday, and most times it comes on Thursdays too. So this past Tuesday morning, he received something very special from the Lord, and the Lord really manifested himself really powerfully through him. And so, Brother Butler, you never short of words. So we just, and this is one of the brothers that Brother Al connected with and encouraged him to come to visit. And yes, he's been here ever since. Good job, Brother Al. All right. He and his wife, they all have joined in, and they have become very, very faithful. So we just want to hear from Brother Butler this morning. The Sanctified Church, believe and testify, that's the thing that kept them so alive. And I believe that if we would have more testimonials of people expressing and confirming the things that God is doing, I believe that we will have a much livelier church, and also we will be on fire. I think it was a testimony, because people were getting up and what? Agreeing with God. They were making confessions. Amen. And telling what God was doing and speaking the word, singing their songs. All right, let's hear from Brother Butler. Let's say praise the Lord for him.
Praise the Lord. Well, as you said, Sister Sheree, that put me on the spot a little bit. But I guess you can't be on the spot when we're trying to testify for the goodness of the Lord. I came from a church background, and as a matter of fact, I even went through a pastoral training in Dallas. And it's kind of hard, though, to align your personal life with your spiritual life sometimes, because sometimes they don't seem to want to run parallel to each other. And for me, it was a road of sometimes thinking that I was doing things within myself, and that it was me, that it was my talent, that it was my abilities that put me where I was. And it's amazing how God always, right at the point where you think you're arrived, and He has the ability to bring you down more than just a notch. Sometimes it's several notches. And for me, that happened. And I had to go back to, quote, my roots. We were talking about that this morning in Sunday school. You have to go back to your roots. You have to go back to your spiritual upbringing. And in going back to my spiritual upbringing, I sit one day in our fine establishment here, David L. Moss, and had my head down, and I kind of looked up and saw a smiling brother looking over there at me, and through all that was going on around him, cursing, the wild talk, the bragging about all of the bad things that some of these guys claim they do, and you know how they kind of up themselves, you can be all you want to be when you're in jail. Well, he was sitting there calm, very peaceful, and so I give thanks to God, but I give thanks to Brother Al for just kind of sitting there calmly, and as I began to talk to him, he just began to praise God and to praise his church and say how much most of the members here or the members here in this church have done to help him out. And so in listening to that, I was thinking to myself, boy, church, I need to get back to that. I find myself sitting up in here, and I know I don't belong in here. And so, in God saying, in God speaking through him, I was able to come here. But one of the things that I haven't done in my life is I've never really, quote, received the Holy Spirit within me to the point where I can speak in tongues. And that was something that I had to work with, because coming up as a Baptist, it just wasn't pressed. If you believe that He is Lord in your heart and you profess it with your mouth, then you will be saved. And that was always my feeling. But that spiritual breakthrough of being able to speak in tongues, hadn't been there for me. And with Pastor Hill's prodding, I guess I'll say that, but also with my wife, who came up in the Pentecostal church, she has a gift of speaking in tongues. I was finally able to get, I guess, a breakthrough to bring my own self down a notch to the point where it makes sense to me. I want to say that, and finally, coming to prayer Tuesday morning, sitting with Pastor Hill and Brother Travis, kind of having that fortunate one-on-one thing, then the Lord was able to work with me, and for the first time I was able to express myself in the spiritual realm.
So I thank God for that. I thank God just for a place where people will work with you, be patient with you. Also, just to give you the ability and give you the know-how, the smarts, the spiritual smart to be able to do what's needed to be done. So Pastor Hill, I thank you for that. I'm still working, still trying to be the best that I can be in Christ.
Amen.
So I ask that you guys pray for me and my family.
All right. Is that good? All right. I believe that he has the, I believe the call of God on his life. And I believe that he could make a pretty good preacher. But he was concerned about, okay, come here, Brother Wendell. I'm calling everybody. But the reason why I'm calling Brother Wendell is because I think that this should be a church that should understand even more concerning the importance of praying in the Spirit. Now, this is probably one of the main hindrances or the main reason why we are where we are, because many have received the Holy Spirit very fluently, but they just don't use their prayer language to perfect their spiritual life like they should. They don't practice it enough. And this is one of the reasons why we want people to come in prayer more, because many times you learn how to pray and get your own breakthrough at home at church first. A lot of times people don't pray that well. They're negligent. They watch, you know, but sometimes when you should be praying, you'd be watching TV or doing something else. So, but to set a time each week where you can come and just spend it, amen, speaking to God, is very precious. Amen. How many can say it's very precious? Now, some of y'all, if I had the opportunity that y'all had to come to church like I, when I was young, 21 years old, I would have jumped at that. I mean, I would have jumped at that really, because I was away from home, didn't have nobody to pray with until the weekend. Okay, I call you up here. The reason I call you up here is because he wants to kind of share how he received the Holy Spirit and his background. I didn't know some of these things you shared with me. Like, let's do that testimony. But I was wondering why he prayed in the Spirit so fluently when he received the Holy Spirit. And he's going to tell you the reason why it came so easy for him. I mean, the clearest, distinct language, very fluently. Amen. I told him that that he has to go to work so early. So, man, he would be a perfect one to be out here at 5 o'clock praying with us. So let's hear from Brother Linda. Let's say praise the Lord for him.
Well, the answer to my speaking in tongues lies in my upbringing. My grandfather was a Pentecostal minister all of his life. He started out as a circuit preacher, and he rode the back hills of Arkansas on a mule, and he held a camp meeting one time in Cape Girardeau, Missouri. And at that time, Pentecost was not an accepted practice. That was something new. And Cape Girardeau was a heavily Catholic community. And the backlash from that community was so strong. What was going on in that tent had such an impact and caused such an uproar, they burned his tent to the ground. So I come from a background of people who are willing to stay on that rock that Sister Dorothy talked about.
Yes.
Willing to put themselves out there and not worry about the consequences.
That's right.
And I have been blessed all my life by that kind of faith and my home.
Yes.
My mother helped found several churches. Y'all don't realize how important it is to pastor to have consistency in our attendance. That's what my mother gave to Pastor. That was the only gift she had to give. She wasn't a wealthy woman, but she could be here. Every time the door was open, she could be here. That was her way of helping families, churches. And I just want to tell you that that struggle that you have inside, whether you're joyous, the expression of that in its truest form, I believe, is speaking in tongues. And that travail that you have when you're down and you're heavy loaded, the true expression of that travail is the speaking in tongues. That's what lifts your spirits, and that's what echoes the joy of your spirit to God. And when he receives it, it's sweetness to God. It's that sweet sound that only we can produce. The angels can't produce what we're producing. And when we speak in tongues, that true affection from our soul to God's, that's what we release. And there's no power like that. There's no power like that. There's no way to express in my English language how I feel about God. I don't have the words. I don't know about you, but I don't have the words. And the Holy Spirit, he knows God. He is God. And through the Holy Spirit, we can speak. We can speak and have our heart known under God. And all I can say to you, when you open your mouth, just let your soul go. Forget your mind. Because your mind, it's not of the consequence that your soul is. It's just a tool that God gave you to carry out what he wants you to carry out. But your soul, freely expressed to God, just open your mouth. And it will flow.
Amen.
All right. Bless you. Holy Ghost morning. I don't know what this will end up. Holy Ghost morning, but we just thank God for Brother Wendell. He almost broke down, but I like that brokenness coming out.
Yes, amen.
All right, Bible said the effectual fervor of the righteous man avails much. How many can say amen? All right, hallelujah, hallelujah. Okay, I know this sister said, I hope you don't forget me, but. Well, I'm just going to tell y'all like it is, because everybody I call, everybody acts shocked. Oh, that shocked me. You know, in sanctified churches, everybody automatically did this. Everybody? And they just couldn't wait for an opportunity. So I don't apologize for calling people, because this is something that what? You're supposed to do. If you don't do it on your own. Some said, well, you can give us 5-day warning. They didn't do that in the sanctified church. If you didn't testify, they would call on you to testify, right? But most of them did it willingly. Is that right? All right, I'm going to give Sister Gaston. Because she said she didn't understand all of this. She was in the church 20 years. She knew she had all she needed. I mean, she felt like she had all she needed and didn't need nothing else. I got all that I need. My dungeon shook, my chain fell off. I knew I was a child of God. And I got all but that there is to get. That's what she felt. Amen. But she found, you need a little bit more time to think about it? You just come on. All right. She's getting pretty good talking in public. Yeah, she can get sanctified. Old-fashioned sanctified women. How many of you said saints of God? All right. But she's going to give you a little history of where she came from and how the Lord finally gave her her breakthrough.
Amen. Praise God. Like Reverend Hill was saying, I came from a Baptist church. have been in the Baptist church for a long, long time. But before I start that, I'm the baby in the family. And I don't remember recalling our family being in church all the time. Travis might know, but I don't. And, you know, we was born and somewhat raised in Midland, Texas. That's where we come from. And while we was there in Midland, Texas, I don't remember us as a family going to church. Travis might know. But when we moved here back in 60-something, I still don't recall us as a family going to church. I don't remember. Until I got a big size girl, I still don't remember us going to church. And I remember some people in the neighborhood will come over to the house and talk to my mom, you know, about coming to church, but I can't remember if she ever did, we ever did. Until I became a teenager, that's when I started going to church with my friend across the street. And I started going to church with them, but I never was in church every Sunday. I never was in church once out of a month, you know, two Sundays out of a month or anything like that. Until I became an adult, that's when I really started going to church. And as I was in the Baptist church, like Brother Frank was saying, you know, they just talked about, you know, you're giving your life to Christ, you know, and that. We didn't stress on speaking in tongues. And when I started coming here, that's when I was introduced into speaking in tongues. And that was foreign to me because I didn't know anything about it. It was new to me, so I didn't know anything about it. So when Reverend was talking to me and was meeting with me and was getting me to start doing it, that was hard for me because I didn't know. Well, yes, I was running from it. You know, he would call, but when he would call, I wouldn't say, "Oh Lord, Reverend calling." I didn't do that because he saw something in me that I didn't see.
Yes.
So, and it, I guess it was something that he saw that I needed work in.
Yes.
And I didn't see that. So, Reverend just kept trying and trying and trying and talking to me. And I had a one-on-one with Reverend and Travis here at church. And, but finally, a long, long time, it was a while. Finally, one Sunday morning, Reverend and I was upstairs in one of those rooms, and he was talking, we was praying and stuff, and then it just came, and I just started speaking in the Holy Spirit.
Right.
And, you know, being here alongside has really done a lot in my life. I have learned a lot from Reverend and all of you all. You know, I'm still a baby Christian, and I'm just trying to do the best that I can.
Yeah.
And I just want you all to please continue to pray for me, that I grow stronger and stronger in the Lord.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Is that good?
Yeah.
Well, I didn't know she was going to do all of that. I mean, she just told the whole story. Boy. Amen. That was good. I don't even want to watch it, Brother Am. She's coming on up. Okay. I just want to do. Sister Smith, do you want to say something? Sister Danielle Smith. And they've been very committed to cleaning the church for the last few weeks. And she has a lot of spiritual experiences, and she's come a long way.
Yeah.
Amen. And I'm just proud of her progress. They are very, very back into the flow. Come on Sunday evenings, and some mornings they be sitting up in here at 5 o'clock. And she has to be at work at what time?
About
6. All right. Okay. You got a story to tell, I know.
I don't want to keep you all, and I don't want to ramble, but God is so good. So good.
where I was 5 years ago being sick and lost so much. I praise the Lord, Pastor Hill, and thank God for my husband. 31 years of marriage, still, we're still together. I just want to say this is a thank you because I love you testimony. Because now I know, being here in Northside, I have the authority. I didn't know I had the authority. I mean, growing up in the church, I didn't pay attention. I grew up Methodist, it's almost Catholic. My husband and I, Baptist, growing, you know, together, church here in Northside. And this church had a lot of issues, spiritual issues, that we didn't know. And it was only a handful of us who believed in the word, healing, speaking in tongues, dreams and visions, and just a few of us who were praying in the spirit. I didn't know what dreams and visions were. I had no idea until one day, and I'd never heard the Lord speak to me until one day we were visiting a church, and I heard him speak to me. And that shocked me. I turned to my right and left to see anybody else heard it, and it was me. And from that point on, the Lord had blessed me in my life working in the school system with another Christian woman who knew. And we would talk, and I would tell her what I was going through. And it's a blessing when you can go ahead, be in your job, and to go ahead and praise the Lord and talk about Him. And just a few of us, my husband and I and other few members, we were having dreams and visions at the same time. We would be in the back of the church when they had these meetings, and people want to get up and bow mouth the church, I mean the pastor, and we would just be silent praying. And I just said, Lord, please shut her mouth up. I didn't say it like that. I mean, Lord, please don't let her say anything wrong. Excuse me. And before I knew it, she got up and she looked confused because she couldn't talk. That's not but the power of God. And what my testimony is to you all today is, thank you for His word. I have grown lately due to Pastor Hill. I am thankful that I'm blessed when I come here to clean up. I'm happy. And you know, I'm growing. I'm trying. Every day is a walk, and I praise the Lord for that. Recently, you know, I asked the Lord for financial, you know, blessings, and I get happy just anything. Because God is good. I'm glad to be here another day. I thank you for, you know, my job. And I asked him for an increase, and he did that. He gave me an increase, and I thank him for that. And somebody, family member, owed us money. She gave us what she could. And then in turn, she needed back, but she didn't want to take it. So it was still in our pocket. God is good. My last testimony is everyday healing and strength. I've been on my job the last 6 years. I work with special needs adults, and they keep me young at heart, because I'm active with them. And due to 2 years ago, I have a knee that's out of place real bad. Dr. Sid, it was like an accident of a football player. I have no pain and whatsoever. I'm not on medication, but I know that I am getting my healing right now, because yesterday I praised Him and spoke in tongue, and I wasn't able to run around. I ran around my house praying yesterday. I thank you that I'm able to exercise. I can do anything I want to do. I can exercise because it is God in my life. I give Him the praise because every day is healing and strength. And I just praise His name because He is worthy to be praised. And Angela, God is in the midst of it. Be still and let Him do what He has to do. Thank you.
All right. All right, she called. Sister Angela, I don't know what the connection that it is. They work together. All right, Sister Angela, come down here. All right. Come down here. Now, this sister here can talk. I don't know whether she might be bashful to start with, but she can flat talk. So we just want to pray that God will begin to loose her and free her. I think she's capable of stirring this church up. And I can see God moving in that family. I didn't know that she was working with Sister Gaynell. My Lord, that had anything to do with anything?
He has changed me so much. And this job, I don't know how I got it. It just, I didn't even fill out the application. This was 3 years ago. I've been working with Gay now for 3 years. And, boy, you know, we have church every day. Every day. We pray together every morning. We stop. We have church. I set the scene, the whole, you know, and everybody like, oh, okay. The ones that don't really care for church or how we do church, I'm like, I'm sorry, but it's another room if you don't want it.
Come on! But,
yeah, it's like,
that's right.
And I have the 97-year-old, 94, 95, they standing up, giving thanks to God, and we just, all the time, Monday through Friday. And I didn't know that God was setting me up. This is, I had the span. And he used what was inside of me already because I'm stubborn, like I said. And I believe in what if it's something, and I believe in going for it. I believe in don't be scared. You keep on. If you got something to say, if it's something that's on your heart you need to share with somebody, share it. Because you don't know. God gives me things to tell people. I need to tell you. I tell you, and I'm like, you take it whatever way, but this is not for me. This is from what I've been grew up, and I have the same thing, you know. Didn't know that all of us together, he like put a group of people together that had like a lot of things in common.
Yeah.
And I've been working out. I was working out. I'm like, okay, you know how you, I've been a big girl my whole life, and I'm like, okay, Lord, I need to do this. And, you know, every day after work, I would work out 45 to an hour. And I'm like, okay, every day I'll be tired. But then he like, I'm here, you need to do this. And I didn't know that he was building me up for what I was gearing to go through. Because if I wasn't strong physically, just as mental and as my mama praying for me, everybody praying for me, I wouldn't be here today. This job had a situation going on with Mo, and with the Sundays that you didn't see me, I was in the hospital. I got rushed to St. Francis in an ambulance. That's when it got serious. I was like, oh Lord, okay, I've been doing everything. I'm praying, everybody's praying, we praying as a family, as a job, and I'm getting weaker and weaker. But before then, I had been working out, trying to start eating right, doing right. And I'm like, this ain't me, because I like to eat meat, I like to eat candy, I like to eat stuff. But then, he was like, okay, well, you have to stop doing this, you have to stop doing this, you have to stop doing this. Like, you gonna make me a vegetarian, Lord? I don't want to be a vegetarian. And I'm like, okay, all right, okay. And then when this stuff started happening, and I'm like, okay, and we praying, and we coming together, and we praying over everybody that's feeling sick in this building, sick all the time. And I'm sick, and I had got so, I'm always full of energy. I'm here, I'm there, I can do 20 things at one time. It don't matter what you put to me, I'm handling. But I started feeling weak. I started getting weak, and I'm like, okay, Lord, what is going on? I go home on the weekend, thank God it's off on the weekend. So then I started building back up. I started feeling better. But then when I go back to work, I would get sick all over again. I would be in somebody's hospital. This went on for a couple of months. Now, this thing got to the point where I'm like, okay, well, I was flipping through the pages, and I'm like, working, and in my job at the same time, I was like, okay, Lord, all these people was praying for me. People was coming from just all over the place. Like, one time I got out of the hospital, and I'm in line, and it's in the middle of the night, and it's just me and Dwayne, and I'm at Walgreens, and I'm having different, it's just like, whoa. Because I'm like, okay, I'm just Angela, Lord. I'm nobody special. I'm just an ordinary female that's just a little bit on the wild side, but, you know, I've never been just, you know, and I never have drunk and I never have smoked, but I guess my personality, people thought, but I could never take in anything. I could never. I don't know if it was the prayers from my family, but I've never been able to take a drink. I've never been able to smoke. I've never been able to do none of that, ever. If I got close to it, if it was something, I would just start to get weak automatically. Just thought, I'm like, oh, Lord, I'm getting, am I allergic to just being close to it? Or what? I don't know. But in between all of this, I'm going through, and I was flipping through the page. I said, okay, this is going to a whole different level. When my health is going down and everything, and then all of a sudden I was flipping to the pages, and I went past lawyers, and I'm like, okay, well, you know, I love this place. We done became a family, so why would I have to go there? But I had to stand. And I had to let them know that I am not playing. I am not, I need y'all for the, all the people that I sit with and I pray with and I talk to, and you know they have 15,000 elements wrong with them. They got this wrong with them. They got that wrong. They wouldn't know if something was hitting them that they couldn't. You know, they just probably added it to the stuff that was already wrong with them. But I was like, Lord, if this is what I'm supposed to stand, and I'm not going to let anybody get hurt, that if you don't even understand when that devil's trying to sneak in and he's trying to take people's lives and do stuff that, you know, that there is no way that I'm going to stand back and let this happen. And I'm like, okay, everybody's sick. Everybody's getting sick to the point where I'm like, oh, Lord, I came in and I'm the one. I was just fine when I came in. Head started pounding. My heart started racing. Everything, I couldn't even see straight. And I went into this big old meeting. It was a meeting going on with the big people. I was like, I need some help. I don't know what's going on, but I am sick, and I need y'all to send me to y'all's doctor. When I did that, I did the right thing, because after that, they cut off everybody from trying to be seen by the doctor, our job's doctor. But that's okay. That's all right. As long as one got in the door, and they got the right one in the door, I got in. They might have cut it off from everybody else, but when I got in, he said, this is the right thing to do. I'm going to go in, and I'm going to go through all of these processes and the doctors. Boy, I got poked and sticked, and I'm allergic to this job, and things can get fixed, and everything can sort to, even if my place is not to be there no more, I know people leave me, but right now, everything will get fixed, and won't nobody's health be at risk anymore if I stand. And when I was flipping to the pages, this lawyer, he was like, okay, well, you have a definite case and everything will be okay. Everything is going to be okay. And I'm like, okay, Lord, all right, okay. All right, this is the right path. Every time somebody came towards me and situations and people was hurt, and then this lady paid for my medicine. I had over $100 at Walgreens. And the woman came behind me. I didn't see her come. And I'm standing there. And this time, I was talking to her, because, see, I wanted some generic. I didn't want the most expensive stuff, because I didn't have that much money in my pocket. So I'm trying to negotiate, what do I really need and what I don't need. And I'm like, okay. And little old woman, she came up, and I wasn't paying attention to it. She said, I'll pay for it. And I'm like, oh, okay, so you're trying to tell me that I got to have this and I got to have that. But I don't need it. Okay, all right. And then she tapped me. And I said, okay, little woman, want me to move out the way? Because she kind of being a little pushy. But okay, I'm going to turn around, because I work with elderly, and I know you have to have extra patience. And all of this, so I turn around, I'm like, yes. But at the same time, I'm thinking, okay, in my head, I'm trying to figure out my digits in my pocket, and I need to figure out what I can do right then. And the woman said, I'll pay for everything. Oh, I'm sorry. But I'm still standing strong, but as the days go on, things is looking so much better and so much. I'm hearing, you know, he just said stand, and I stood, and I'm doing what I'm supposed to do, and thank God that I'll be okay. It's gonna be okay.
Boy, I didn't know Angela had all that in her. I should have known. Boy, we need an accommodation. I agree that we need an Angela like that. I know what I'm saying. Somebody that's bold and won't back down. I mean, I think she's going to be a terror against the enemy. All right, we'll just thank God for that. And I have a whole lot I can do. Sister Lenita, I don't know why the Lord just dealt with me this morning. I said, I see something President Obama said, I'm evolving. But I see something evolving in your life. And I just want you to come and just share what it is, because the Lord just keep dealing with me, because you're different than any time that you've been in this church.
Yes.
Something is going on, yes. And we just want to know a little bit more about, a little bit more about what God is about to do through you and what he's doing, getting ready to do. Let's say praise the Lord for sister. All right, we're going to be patient. It's much cooler today than it was last week. Last week we had two air conditioners that were not functioning properly, but we feel a little cooler. How many feel a little bit more comfortable today? It was very hot outside. Okay, Sister Lenita, we just want to hear a word from you. The Lord just instructed me to just have you have a word.
Problems, and we were, because we have this aunt
And I left church because they would take her to church. Her granddaughter, who had her car, would take her to church. They would get her dressed, but they wouldn't pick her up, and they would leave her in church for hours, you know. And she's an old lady, and she has Alzheimer's. So I decided that I will take my lunch hour, take her to church on Wednesdays, and take her to church. She had to be at Sunday school, and she doesn't like to be late. So me and Samari, we grew up in French, New Jerusalem, so we can get her back and forth because that's what she wanted to do. And something came in my heart to do it, you know, to put my life on hold, to take care of her because the rest of them wouldn't do it. And so now my two sisters are not speaking to one another. I'm in the middle, my cousin not speaking. And I speak to everybody, but I decided to opt out. This is y'all's problem, and I'm not going to deal with it anymore because I did everything that I could in my power that I had. And so when we were doing it, her son came over, "You're stealing her money." And I'm like, "I'm not stealing your money. I don't even go visit your mom anymore." So we all just left the situation alone. So I'm praying and hoping that all the sisters would come back together and be close like we used to be. And I can't believe that he even brought it up. I'm like, wow, he hit it right on the dome. And I was thinking about it that morning when he brought it up about this, my sisters. But now my aunt is in a nursing home. And so that alleviated everybody having to take care of her. But we do go and visit her. And I mean, she doesn't remember anything. And when we come, she wants us to take her home to Muskogee. She ain't lived in Muskogee since she was 19 years old, so we know. But that's where she wants to go. And that's where everybody's buried at. So we don't know what she's talking about. But I just ask that you all pray for me for my job situation as well as my family situation, and things will be a lot better. And also pray for my older son. He's getting ready to have surgery. And I don't like the doctor because his spirit and my spirit didn't coming together, and when he was talking to Mario, he turned his back to me like this. And Mario said, "You have anything to say from the doctor?" I said, "If it was me, I wouldn't use him. Because number one, when he walked in the office, he should have spoke to both of us, and he didn't. And I have a problem with that. So he's not going to change doctors. So I'm just asking if you would pray for Moses for him when he has his surgery. Just join with me."
All right.
Amen.
All right, praise the Lord. That's good, good, good. Just want to say that this service this morning, again, is a little different because sometimes we need to hear from you. And, a whole lot of things coming out this morning that's going to really give me a different outlook on a whole lot of things. I just want to mention some of the most faithful, committed members of our Bible study. They don't have to do this, Brother George and Sister Panola. On Sunday evenings, they're very faithful. God scheduled to preclude us from them from coming on Wednesday night, but they are very diligent about Sunday evening, whatever we have. And also the Smiths, raise your hand, Smiths. Okay, they're very diligent. These are very lively discussions. Brother Smith, boy, he almost reminds me of a professor, college professor. He gets so much information and knowledge about the Word of God. So we just want them to know that we really appreciate them. And Brother Mariko and Sister Jessica, they've been coming on Wednesday in the daytime with the children, making a special sacrifice. Amen. They just gather the kids up and come for a Bible study on Wednesday. Isn't that remarkable? How God is putting it on the heart of the people to, amen, study the Word and to be faithful and committed to the things of God. We just want to call, amen, Brother Curtis, join us on a Wednesday. We're going to hold them to that Wednesday. It seems to be the best time for him. All right, so we really appreciate you. Want to say something? Sister Fenella, but we just thank God for you. You want to say something? Okay, come on, say something. We're going to pray in a few minutes because the Lord has put prayer on my heart. We're going to close out with prayer. There's some specific things that we're going to pray for. And we just kind of
this family morning, Sunday morning family, because we need to know more about our family. How many learn something about your family this morning that you didn't know? All right.
Good morning, Saints. I would just like to say that the Lord has been blessing me tremendously since I moved back to Tulsa. It was a kind of hard decision, but even when I went back home to my church that I had joined when I was 15, I would always tell the pastor that I'm going back to Tulsa because Oklahoma, because when I came here, I really grew a lot and got stronger in the Lord, and it was due to Northside Christian Center, and it was due to me not being around immediate family, but just my husband and my children. So I really didn't have anyone to run to or depend on, so I got stronger and stronger in the Lord. It's just something about Tulsa that drew me here. And so I've really just grown, and I love Northside, and I got the my gift of speaking in tongues here with Sister Mary Ingalls living. One Sunday, she said, anybody want the gift of speaking in tongues, come down and you can get it. And I came down and believed in faith, and she prayed with me, and I got it all of a sudden. I was very excited about that. And it has helped me a whole lot. And I also want to thank and praise God for my husband, who has come a very long way in God. I mean, God has really worked a miracle in him to get him where he is today. Coming with me on Sunday evenings, coming to church with me. And I would just like to comment on him for always supporting me and everything, because being a woman in the ministry, a lot of men would like, you know, back down and say, no, this ain't for you. But my husband has been fully supportive of me, never turned me down, always proud of me, support me speaking at funerals, doing weddings, whatever I do, he have always been there for me, and I just want to commend him for that. And I just want to thank Pastor Hill for being a good spiritual father in my life. I mean, a very good spiritual father. I mean, the leading and the anointing and everything that I have gotten from him and Sister Hill has really helped me mature a lot in my Christianity and in my growth.
Amen.
And I thank you
all.
Amen.
All right. Well, I haven't preached yet, and y'all might feel like you don't have enough word yet from all of these. But I just have to say, Brother Hull, I just want to just pull you out just a moment, just say a word, because you have made the most remarkable, complete turnaround that anybody I ever seen in this ministry, and he's all for God. And I just believe that God is, ain't fooled him yet, but he got him going his direction. Let's say praise the Lord for Brother Ellen Holman.
Thank you, Honor God. Pastor Hill. Good morning, Saints. Yeah, that's true. This ministry I've always found very, very encouraging. Because, this, you know, on the north side, at the time when I was coming up, you know, and when we came to this ministry by the witness of Pastor Hill and his wife, they were out. We met them that way. But this ministry, I found out, reaches both your spirit, it ministers to your body, and your soul. And that's perfect, because it covers the whole human spectrum of a person.
Yes.
So, you know, with that, you know, I'm really encouraged, and each member should be encouraged, because we get the whole spiritual thing of life here. You know, we get it in our mind,
yes.
We get it in our body, and we get it in our soul. So, you can't cover any other bases. So with that, you know, it's helped me grow over the years tremendously. You know, he's taught me to acknowledge myself. You know, it's fine we come together and seek knowledge, but, you know, we spend more time away from the church than we do here.
Come on.
So in that time that we spend away, be seeking the things of the Spirit. Be seeking the things about God, because we're only here traveling for a brief moment. We're only here for a short moment, 70 years or so. You know, I'm of age right now, me and my wife. You know, we're running into our 50s, and, you know, the older we get, the closer you get to God. You know, when I was a young man, I did the young things, you know. I was doing what I was doing as a young man, but as I began to get older, had a bout with cancer, had a bout with me and my wife, you know, our relationship. We had been married for about 29 years. She was the only lady I knew, and I got out there and, you know, left the ministry, turned my back on the Lord. You know, then I came down with cancer, and God healed me. He changed me. Once I had that encounter with that life-threatening decision,
God healed me of it. Life never been the same. He is the Lord and Savior of my life. He is the King. And you know what? To leave here and spend eternity somewhere without knowing Him, there's no more chances after that. Once, this is the only level that we have to get to know Jesus personally, right here in this life. But this is the only time we have, because when we pass on, then that's eternity. So, being the things that He's done in my life, in my wife's life, in my family's life, and as He's done throughout my life, now I have the utmost respect for the Lord Jesus Christ. You know, because ultimately it's God who judges us. God. So if you want to put your whole heart and your whole soul into something, put it in the Word of God. Because that's the living thing. That's the thing that's going to change. That thing that's going to change. That's able to get into your soul and change you. He'll change you. I mean, it's not rocket science stuff. God has set it up this way that if we hear His Word and we pay attention to it and we study His Word, that it'll get inside of us and it'll grow to a level where it can really change. It'll change your life to believe that it's nothing impossible with God. Nothing. It's nothing impossible to the God that I serve.
Come on.
Nothing impossible. And I learned that here at Northside. I mean, I went to a lot of ministries, but like I say, this ministry is going to teach you in your mind, in your spirit, in your body, nutrition, health. It's a whole package here. It's always been a whole package. You know, and hopefully more ministries that get into that, because that's the whole man, the three-part man of us. And that's very important. That's the other thing.
All right. Well, that's good. I believe he got a little preaching here. I believe he got a little preaching. Really, I want you to give me a Sunday. You want to see. So, he's running all over the country, evangelizing and talking to his friends. Amen. So, he's ready to tell the story. Amen. So, I'm going to tie it down this summer, one Sunday. Let me know. I know you got a lot of things going on this summer. But let me know. Okay. Now, I'm going to have to do this. And then we're going to have to taper off. But one thing the Lord was dealing with me about was that one of the, let's see, first brother, your husband. Okay, where's him at? Okay, he has a little, he has a son. Okay, maybe you can try to get him in here just for a second. Okay, but anyway, Brother Derek, if you could, I just felt led Wednesday to focus on some health issues, some things that would really cause you to have more energy to get up and come to pray. Derek has a wealth of information, and he's hung around with doctors, and he knows just so much stuff that I don't know. And I'm just going to have him to just talk off the top of his head, or some focus on a whole lot of issues that we're having problems with, and how you can feel a lot better, and how you can have a lot more energy. And I feel like that would be good for this coming Wednesday night. And I want to have some refreshments in the back, y'all can. But I want to encourage everybody. He's going to tell you some things that you, I guarantee you, that you've never heard before. And so if you really want to benefit from this, let's try to be here on Wednesday evening. This is a little a Bible study. Amen. Because we're trying to take it all along together. Brother Henry, just come here just for a second. Brother has had his share of ups and downs. Sometimes I think he's getting down more than up. But he always bounces back. Always bounces back. I don't know. Amen. Alright, sometimes I have been tempted to almost write him off. But then he pops up. He pops up from somewhere. Gets back on the track. And boy, he's in the game again. All right, so just give us a word. Just tell us if you're going to stand fast in the liberty wherewith Christ has set you free, or whether you're going to go the devil's way, which one are you going to do?
I'm going with God.
You know, I've had my ups and downs, and I try to do things myself, and basically, it just got worse. Without God, I'm nothing. And I told all my God all my problems, everything I was having to Him, and He's been working with me, and boy, He's took me out of a lot of ruts. Yeah, without Him, I wouldn't be standing here today. I praise Him, you know, every single day. There's still a lot of work I got to do and stuff, but little by little, you know, I'm coming along. And, you know, like I said, without them, you know, I'd be nothing.
That's right.
How I came upon this church, too, was just Northside Christian Center. I was delivering furniture one day here, and for some reason, Pastor was with me as we were carrying up the desk, and I wanted to tell him something. A feeling came over me. And I don't know why this feeling came over me, but I told him that if it was me, I would give him this furniture that he didn't deserve to pay for. And I told him, I don't know where that came from or what. I said, but to me, I just felt like crying right away, you know. And I've been to a lot of churches and never felt like this. So he goes, wow, you know, I sent him back a little bit. And he goes, well, you need to come, you know. I think you find yourself a church. So a couple of months went by, and I basically didn't show up. You know, I went back to doing what I was doing. And to make a long story short, I had gotten in a little beef with these biker guys, and I ended up grabbing my gun and went looking for one of them. And I didn't know the north side too good. And guess where I ended up? Right here. Of course. Put the 45 in my hands. And now what do I do? You know? And from that day on, you know, I've been coming.
Okay. Now, what about your baby now?
We wouldn't have our son if it wasn't for God. Because our son was taken by DHS. We had, you know, a terrible relationship. God continuously changes us, you know, and it's a process and it takes time. But if we give it to Him, He has the power to transform you. I was a mess. I was not like a good mother at all. And when Henry and I would come to church, the Spirit would come over me.
Yes.
And I would change.
Yes.
And I would read my Bible. And God changed
yes.
me. And then things would happen. And I'd go back to medications. But God has always been good. He has always been there for our family. And
yes.
He's always been the source of strength. Even when things get rocky and things are hard, God is good. If you just look to Him, you know, He can save you from anything. Things you think are impossible,
yes.
He can save you from
yes.
it.
Yes.
Things like DHS and a judge
yes.
And the police,
yes.
they have more power. No, they don't.
Yes.
God has more power
yes.
than DHS
yes.
and the judges. And
yes.
all the people that you think that you are afraid of. If you give your fears to God,
yes.
He will take over and He will transform your life.
Oh, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. All right. That is amazing. Amazing what God is speaking through you all today. All right. Brother Grimes, you think that this is something that you want to hook into? Amen. I believe that your blessing, your fulfillment, your completion is in the Word of God. So, we just want to connect with you, and whatever day you can fit into your schedule time, we want you to get plugged in, because we believe that God is willing to work that miracle in your life. I know, I just confirmed that He's willing and ready to work that miracle in your life. Amen. Praise the Lord. Okay, we got a visitor from Blue Zen. Let's say praise the Lord for her. She reminds me so much of another lady. I love you. Amen. She's just a real blessing. She'll be here 2 months. We got to be here from her. All right, we're going to let you go. Sister the whole one, I just wanted to just say that. Just come here just one moment. You got special. She is perhaps one of the most faithful, committed person in prayer. Travis's prayer, our prayer. She's probably one of the most faithful and committed. And I can't remember a single prayer meeting hardly that she didn't get a breakthrough. And she does it all by mostly agreeing with God, speaking the word. And when God quickens a word, she says that word and she keeps saying it until her breakthrough comes and the tongues begin to be released. She just waits for the appropriate word to be said and then she latches on. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. And then she began to just speak and just talk herself and confess and affirm herself to her breakthrough every day. And this is what, you know, we've been trying to teach this over how many years we've been trying to teach this. And she's one of the ones that got it probably better than anybody else. I mean, she can just say certain things in prayer and her breakthrough will come every time. And all she is doing, lining her words up with God's word and saying what God says about her. Glory! Hallelujah. And we just thank God for this great ministry, this support that we have in prayer. Amen. Let's just say praise the Lord. Anything you want to say before you sit down?
You know, God is good. Amen. You know, it was Thursday morning at prayer. Pastor Hill blessed me so much. You know, he blesses me when he be praying because I don't come out here for nothing at 4 o'clock, you know, 5 o'clock. I don't do that. I want God to change my life. You know, and if I put the word in me, like I said, I have a memory. Well, I can't remember the verse and chapter, but once Pastor Hill says it, I can say it, you know. And I said, and he told me, when I come to prayer, when Brother Travis is up there, when Pastor Hill is up there, you sit right here. And that's how I've been getting my breakthrough. And things have been working out. Yesterday, you know, when Pastor Hill blessed me Thursday, and he said, Judy, you bless me. I said, no, you blessing me. Because God has turned things around in my life. And yesterday, I got the CD. You know, it's No Greater Love Than I Have in Christ. And I put that CD, and I said, I don't want to be like Pastor Hill, but I want to be like Pastor Hill. I want to put those scriptures in me. And Alan is my witness. He was gone. But I sit there all yesterday morning, and I put my praise and worship on. And I said, I'm going to be what Pastor Hill wants us to pray. And I put it all down there. So when I look at this book now, and the word comes to me, I got like 20 scriptures that I put down that when I just look at it, I can say it. Because God has, you know, I've been praying for my feet. I told Alan, I went to a foot doctor, what do you call a specialist, Thursday. And I said, you know what? Because I usually put Bengay on my foot every morning. But I told Alan yesterday, I ain't put no Bengay on there. And I know God has turned me around because I've been faithful in a few things. He's made me faithful over a lot. And I have to give God that courage because I pray all day long, and I pray, I try to get with corporate prayer because I know the yokes would be broken if everybody's praying. The Holy Spirit is working. And like I said, I'd be broken with certain words. And my foot now, I said, Alan said, I don't know, but somebody asked me about ushering. And I said, it won't be long now, because I see a change since last Thursday. And I have to give God the thanks and the glory that things have been changing. And then it's like Monday night prayer. Calvin, he just blessed my soul. I mean, things just blessed my soul. I mean, it was so wonderful. We just, he prayed, you know, everybody said what they wanted him to pray for. He got up there and we joined hands. And you know, I have to say, Sister, Brother Al's wife, she was praying in the spirit and it touched my soul. She doesn't know, but she touched my soul because she was praying in spirit. She doesn't pray like I do, but I could hear her and it touched my spirit. And the prayer was so powerful. You know, every Monday night, I mean, the power of the Holy Ghost just goes on through me. And I just thank God for Brother Travis. That's a good man. He is a very good man. He's very faithful. You know, and that's what I look for. Pastor Gil don't have to worry because he's always on time. And I say, you know what? If Brother Travis is here, I'm going to be here. I'm going to be in this prayer with him, connected with him in his situations, in my family situation. God has turned it around. Because yesterday, I said, I am ready. I have my scriptures. When I just open my book up, the ones that he gave me, the power of the Holy Ghost is going to work through me, that things are going to work out. And they have worked out in my life. And I want to thank God.
All right. Amazing. Is that good? Shirley Brown also, she's another one of those. I don't have her to say anything, but she does what she's supposed to do. So Irene is kicking in. Amen. Praise God. She's got a big project coming up. She'll come down soon. That's all said. We're going to let you go. And the reason why, I just want to tell you the reason why. Now, how many in this audience have not received the fullness of the baptism of the Holy Spirit with the Spirit and the evidence of speaking in tongues? If you haven't received that experience, it's indicated by the lifting of your hands. You are here today. Amen. And you want to receive that experience. So we just want to say this. The reason why we exhort you to come to prayer, I'm going to tell you the reason why. Because prayer is something that you can't. It's not something you learn. I mean, not that you can just learn it independent of doing it. You have to come and be under the anointing, and God will begin to what? He'll begin to use you mightily in prayer. Every opportunity. Now, some of y'all make the mistake because many times you don't persevere and be in prayer like you should. The only way that you're going to learn it, amen, is that you're going to have to be around people that's praying. That's the way prayer is learned. That's how I learned how to pray. I was around mothers and people that stood before the Lord sometimes for an hour or 2 or 3 hours. That's how you learn how to pray. It's not something that we can just teach you, step 1, 2, 3, 4. You just have to what? You have to catch it. You have to be in prayer. You have to exert yourself. Brother Travis, now they have a method now from 7 to 7:30. They give you lead time. You get in there and try to what? Initiate your prayer. Say what you want to say to God. Do it your own way. Meditate. Try to pray through whatever God gives you. Speak it out or do whatever you want to do for 30 minutes. That's how we learn how to pray. We initiated our prayer, prayed in the Spirit. The Lord quickened something for us to speak out.
Yes.
Amen. We did that. And you will get an opportunity to pray for 30 minutes. And after 30 minutes, then we began to switch over to corporate prayer and do some other things, confessions and things like that. But that 30 minutes, if some of y'all just sit here and twirl your thumbs, look wise and otherwise, Amen. I mean, that is very important. 5 years from now, is amen. What will be happening to you depends on the time that you spend talking with the Lord. Amen. Making the right use of your opportunities. Lord, sometimes I feel like that we are just neglecting such a great commodity, an opportunity to come to pray. Amen. At 6 o'clock in the 5 o'clock in the morning. Prime time. Everybody just look at somebody and say, prime time. Amen. I mean, most times you come, you're gonna be dog tired after a long day's work. Prime time. I mean, everything is so clear and crispy. Amen. The very they said what? Catch the word. Amen. Boy. When you miss that, I hate to think what my life would be like if I had prayed. I wouldn't be doing what I'm doing now. I wouldn't have held on like I'm holding on now. My family, after all of these 50 years, everything is working like clockwork. Effectual fervent prayer of a righteous man knows what. I'm going to tell y'all flat-footed that the greatest mistake you're making is that you try to hold back, cut back, you just do it whenever you feel like you want to do it. And you're going to miss out on so many blessings. I mean, so many things are going to pass you up. Prayer is the key.
Yes, it is.
Prayer is the key.
Yeah, yeah.
We got to learn how to do it.
Yeah.
We got to learn how to persist in prayer.
Yeah.
Because your future is dependent upon that.
Yes, it is.
Your family's future is what continues. Here at 9 o'clock. Sometimes I call Brother Travis. I said, Brother Travis, I want you to take over. I can't come this morning. I don't feel right about it. I just feel like that's the time for me to meet the Lord.
Yes.
Special time. All the other times are good too.
Yes.
But there are special times I've set aside to meet with the Lord. So let's lift up our hearts to the Lord today.
Yes.
And I think that what prayer you ought to be praying and what desire you ought to be having is that you ought to try to figure out how you can make a stronger commitment to prayer.
Yes.
Stronger commitment. And focus on praying the word.
Yes, that's it.
Saying what God says. Let God quicken that through you while you are speaking in prayer. Make melody in your heart with scriptures.
Yes.
Let's begin to enrich our spiritual lives and come up to a level where God's power and word can become more real to us. This is our prayer, saints.
Yes.
This is our prayer. And I want you to just join in with me. Amen. Now, let's join in because this ministry, we have quite a few. We have two couples ready to start marital classes. And this, I mean, they're not even here today. Two couples, and I'm sure some of others. And, I mean, people are desiring what we have. There are a lot of people that's going to be plugging into this ministry. Are we going to pray and set the tone and create the environment for God to work and do what he wants to do?
Yeah.
Or are we going to feel like it's too big of a sacrifice to give your prayer on Monday night, amen, one of the mornings, I mean, even if it's every once a week, every other week, spend some time, amen, with saints praying because the effectual fervent prayer for righteous men of the other side. Amen. Father, today we thank you, Lord, for the spirit of prayer. Oh God, you're able to do exceeding abundantly above all that we can think or even ask. But it's according to the power that works in us. It's according to the power. It's according to the motivation and the zeal and the fervency. It's according to what we have and how bad we want. More of you. Father, today we thank you in Jesus' name because we know that you are not slack concerning your promises as men count slackness, but you are long-suffering, willing that none would perish, and you want all of us to come to a point that we can be used and your spirit can be manifested through us. Father, we thank you in Jesus' name. Lord, if there's one prayer that I would like to place before you, and believe you, Lord, for the manifestation of the answer, the fulfillment of it.
is to quicken in the heart of all of your people under the sound of my voice the importance of prayer. Corporate prayer. Corporate prayer. Praying in the Holy Ghost. Making melody in your hearts to the Lord in hymns, songs, and spiritual songs. Not just a conventional prayer, not just a prayer that of words only, but a prayer that's from the heart and that resounds deep down within. Father, today in the name of Jesus, we pray that the spirit of prayer will become more and more alive and that we will give our lives to the word and to prayer. Father, we pray today in Jesus' name. Those that have not been able to hook into Bible study, Lord, we give ourselves to the word, and to prayer. Lord, those are the things that you have chosen to perfect us and to place us in a position to receive all of those blessings that you have promised. We got to pray them into manifestation. We got to speak them into manifestation. We got to make melody in our hearts with them and get them into manifestation. But the word comes by hearing. Faith comes by hearing. And hearing by the word of God. Father, we commit this to you, all of those that, hallelujah, we want you, Lord, to speak to their hearts. And we want you, Lord, to quicken the importance of how important prayer is to our families, our future, our home, our success, and the things that you want to do. We do it in Jesus' name. Everybody just lift your hand. Just say in Jesus' name. Just say in Jesus' name. Say in Jesus' name. Say in Jesus' name. Amen. Turn around and tell three verses. Men ought to always pray. And not turn out bad. Always a prayer. All right, hold on just a second. Just before you leave.